This video is about making a 3D model of the famous Canon RF 2870 f/2 lens in Blender 2.80. I'll be showing you all the important steps for making the model, adding shades, creating a small animation using this model. The first step is to find some good reference images. I usually use Google images, and when I search, I will add terms like blueprint or technical diagram along with the search term to get detailed images with all dimensions and technical data. Most of the cases it will work, but over cameras I couldn't find any such detailed images. Even though I found these images, a half cut view of the exact same lens and a side view. I think this is enough to make a good quality 3D model, except for the precise dimensions. Next step is to load the side view reference image to the top orthography view in Blender. Okay, now let's start modeling by making a vertex and move it to the lower side corner of the lens and extrude until it covers one side of the lens. For most of the parts, you can follow this same method. Now it's time for using the screw modifier to get the round shape. Set the angle to 360 degree, change the axis to Y, set the number of steps to 80 and render step to 120 or higher depending upon your hardware. Next step is to add bevel for edges. But here, all edges are not the same. These two edges have same kind of bevel, all other edges have different kind of bevel. So we have to use multiple bevel modifiers to add such details. We can use vertex limit method to create a separation between the different types of bevels. For that, first we want to create a vertex group. Create a vertex group in vertex groups that can be found in the object data tab. Select the vertices which have same kind of bevel and assign it to the group. Then create a new group and assign the rest of the vertices. Now in modifiers tab, add bevel modifier, change the limit method to vertex group, choose the group and adjust the width and segments to match with the edges. Now select the other bevel modifier, adjust the width and segment and set the limit method to other vertex group. Now in order to remove the flat surface, we have to add subdivisions and make sure to remove vertices from the vertex group that don't need bevel modifier. Okay, now this zoom and focus ring have same kind of geometry, and also the wall model is a repetition of this small segment. So we can make it from a plane and use array modifier and curve modifier to create the wall shape. Scale the plane to match with the segment, inset, extrude the center face, scale it and apply the bevel modifier to finish up the segment. Now add array modifier and increase the segment. For converting this into surround the camera body, we can use bezier curve. Add a bezier curve, rotate and move it to match with the size of zoom ring. Now select the segments and add curve modifier and pick the bezier curve as object. Once it is finished, we can use the same copy of curve and zoom ring to create the focus ring. Now let's make the ISO ring. ISO ring can be modeled in the same way we did for the zoom and focus ring. Create a plane and scale it to match with the segment. Subdivide the plane along X and Y axis to make the geometry. Here we can use knife tool to cut along the inner edge of the ring. Select all vertices which needs projection and move it along Z axis. Then add array modifier and increase the count. Now for the curve, we can copy it from the zoom ring. Also move and scale it to match with the ISO ring. Now select the ISO segment. Add the curve modifier and choose the new curve. And adjust it to match with the ISO ring. For making this red ring, we don't have to start from scratch. We can copy vertices from the main body and scale it to match with the ring and make it as a separate object. Now this part doesn't cover the wall body. Now we have to create it as a separate object. We can start from the main body itself, copy vertices from the main body and go to screw modifier and reduce the angle to 45 degree. Add a mirror modifier, check the X and Z axis. Apply the screw modifier. Close the end face and adjust it to match it with the reference image. Now rest of the parts are also made in the same way. Nothing too new to it. So let's start modeling the inside parts. For this we need half cut view image. Load the image as a reference in top orthography view. Here also we can use screw modifier to make this lens and other parts. So let's copy some vertices from the main body and make it as a separate object. And then move and extrude vertices to shape like the lens. Now for moving this vertex to center, select the vertex, go to end panel item tab, change the vertex x value to 0. And also add bevel to vertices using the limit method. Other lenses are also made in the same way. Just copy this lens and start reshaping it. Now let's make the buttons, this one and this one. For this we need an addon called BoolTool, which is already available in Blender, but we have to enable it in preference. and it will be located at the end panel edit tab. Now create a cube, move, scale and rotate to match with the button. Now select the four edges and bevel it to match with the buttonhole. Select the cube and main body and apply difference in brush boolean so that we can change the location and size of the hole without affecting main body. Now let's make the button. Select the cube, duplicate it and remove the brush boolean and make the button by subdividing and scaling. Also add bevel to make it perfect. And follow the same method for other buttons as well. For adding text and marks on the surface, we can use text tool in Blender. For example, let's make this text. Create a text 28-70, scale it. And in order to attach it on the surface, we can use shrink wrap modifier. Select the font and add the shrink wrap modifier and increase the offset to 01001 to make it outside the surface. Follow the same method for other text and marks as well. Once modeling is finished, go to shading workspace for adding materials. Please turn on the node wrangler add-on for fast and better workflow. First, we can set up the world environment. Switch to world shader nodes, add an SDR image to light up the environment. Now switch to object shader nodes, select the main body and add a new material. Change the color to test the color variation with the lighting setup. Now for making this type of textures, we can use noise texture. For adding this mapping node and texture node, I used the node wrangler add-on. Ctrl plus T is the shortcut. Increase the scale to 200 and detail value to 16. Add a color ramp node to adjust the noise value. And now connect it to the principal VSDF. Now for the black color, add a mix RGB node between color ramp and the principal VSDF node. Change the second color to black and increase the factor. And we can add more details like displacement bump by using a displacement node or a math node. Here I used a math node. Add a math node, connect it to material output and change the operator to multiply. Reduce the second value to 01002 and connect the color ramp node output to the first value. And this front bar node does not have any detail like the main body, so we can use a dark gray color here. The zoom, focus and ISO rings are made of rubber, but it have details like the main material. So we can use a copy of main material and reduce the metallic value. We can see this part have same textures like the main body. So we can use the main material as a second material in this ring. And rest of the materials are just basic materials, which is based on principal BSDF and nothing special about it. But for the text and marks, I used a copy of the main material with a light gray color. For this lens material in EV, make sure to turn on screen space reflections and refractions in the render tab. And also in material tab, turn on the screen space refraction and set the refraction depth to 0.1. And also change the blend mode to alpha blend. And for better lighting, I have added 3 area lights surrounding the model. Now let's look at the animation part. For quick animations, we can use an add-on called a turnaround camera, which is available in Blender 2.8 by default, but you have to turn it on in preference, and it will be located at the end panel view tab. Now select the main body, set the Z axis to 1 for rotating around the Z axis, and press the turnaround button. For the transparent effect, we can add keyframes to alpha and blend mode in materials. At frame 0, set the alpha 0 and blend mode to alpha blend. At frame 200, set alpha 1 and blend mode to opaque. And do these same steps for all the materials. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching. You can find the final renders in my ArtStation profile. I will put a link in the description. Also, you can buy this model for a small amount or some other free models from my Gumroad store. Please subscribe this channel, and if you have any doubts, let me know in the comment section below.